is. What are you going to do?
Screw it, right there. I don't know if we can see anything or not.
What are you doing?
No.
Guess I'm done with my show, eh?
Can I repeat myself?
I don't know.
I got rebuked one time in church, or the church group, and I got told off pretty hard. I don't know what you can see in her.
Use the cord.
It was a big bone, and it was a juicy bone. So, he's trotting down the road, heading for home, and he has to cross the bridge. And as he's crossing the bridge, he looks over into the water. And he sees in the reflection in the water a dog with this big, beautiful bone. And he wants the bone. So he drops the bone he has, and jumps into the water to get the other dog's bone. And his bone floats on down the river and it's gone. What's he got? Nothing. I had a cribbed well, dug well, that produces water, but it needs work. So I'm on my way home, and I see something else. It's just a reflection, isn't it? Let's drill a well. Let's put in who wants creek water when you can have really good well water, you know what I mean, from deep down in the rock. There I am. Got nothing. So obviously, God's teaching me that I followed something that I shouldn't. I followed my heart. I wanted a nice well for the renter and everything, you know what I mean? Good water. I followed my heart. Look where it got me. $4,000 poorer, and I got a big friggin' hole in the ground. And I got no water. But I still have, I'm lucky. I can chase my bone down the creek and at least get my bone back. But I'll still have to put money into the cribbed well in order to have good quality water, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And enough of it. That's the big thing. Enough of it. That little well doesn't produce enough. It has to be dug deeper. More cribs put on and sink it down deeper to get more water. But I've been much smarter to stick with what I had. So did I sin in going on this quest to get what I want? And the answer is yes. The answer is yes. Truth has shown me that. I dug a dry well. And the Lord has shown me that. Truth has shown me that. I gave you water, he said, and you had water. You dug that well years ago by hand. All you had to do was put a bit of money into it, bring in a big machine, and dig it deeper. Would have been easy for you. It wouldn't have cost you $4,000. The line's already there underneath the ground and everything. All you had to do was punch it through the new basement wall and hook it up to the pump. That's all you had to do with. Was I happy with that? No. Oh, I want bigger. I want better. I sinned. It's that simple. And yet men, these self-righteous hypocrites say, oh, we don't sin. We don't sin. You lying sacks of dirt. We all sin. We all make mistakes, and every mistake we make is a sin. Every one of them. Do you get it? That's life. People say, I don't need your Jesus. Well, by George, have Have fun, asswipe, saving your own ass. Because you're not doing a very good job of it, and I've never met a man that could. You know what I mean? You ever meet a man that didn't make mistakes? Not me. Not me. I don't need your Jesus. You don't need my Jesus. Well, you sure as hell need somebody to save your worthless ass. That you do for sure. You need someone to save your worthless ass. Because you can't save it yourself. So you better find yourself a Messiah somewhere. You can't do it yourself. It's impossible for man to save himself. People say, we don't need a Messiah. We can do it ourselves. Well, good luck. Good luck. In all your great perfection, you're so frigging perfect. You know what I mean? I've got wisdom, says Eve. I have understanding. Yeah. Doesn't seem to be working out too good, does it? Look at Ed drilling his stupid well. Doesn't seem to be working out very good. It's the way it works. It's the way it works. And it's hard to take. Hard to take. We're going to suffer for a while, boy. Without that money, we're going to suffer. But, and we won't be renting because we've got no water. You know what I mean? We don't have enough water to run the cabin. So we won't be running. That won't be helping us. So it's going to hurt for a bit. Oh, well. We'll get through it. I'm not afraid of work. As long as my body can do it, I'm not afraid of work. If I have to redo the old well, you know what I mean? Just the two of us, we have to dig it out, we'll dig her out. And we'll make it work. We'll make it work. Say hi to everybody.
Finish now.
Speak and say hi, please.
Hi, guys.
There you go. Well, I guess I'll go on. What do you do when you hurt? You go crawl in a corner and do something? I don't know what the hell. What do they call that?
Lick your wounds.
Go outside. I'll go lick my wounds. Jesus is Lord. Love one another. Bye.
At least your name's not George and you're not going to the driveway.
Tell a joke.
No.
Tell a joke. Come on, come on, come on.
You tell it better. You tell the joke. Give me the camera and you tell the joke.
Okay.
You're better.
I think it's still turned on.
It's still turned on.
You still there?
Yeah.
Hi, everybody. We're trying to smile because it hasn't been a good day. George. You heard the one about George, eh? There was a lady who was married to George, and she was out shopping one afternoon. In the course of her shopping spree, she ran into a family doctor, a physician. And she thought to herself, I'm going to ask the doctor. So she caught the doctor and kind of got him off on a little side aisle there, and she said, I'm worried about George, my husband. The doctor said, oh, what's wrong? She said, he's taken to eating dog food. She says, I can't figure it out for the life of me why he's got this dog food fetish, but she said, he just does. And she said, I'm worried, is it going to hurt him? And the doctor said, no, most dog foods won't hurt you, you're not going to die from it. He said, I think it's just some kind of passing fad. You'll get over it. So the lady was happy with the doctor's advice. They both went about their business. About a year went by. The lady hadn't seen the doctor in that length of time. And this time the doctor is on the street one day and he spied the lady, and the first thing he thought of was George eating dog food. So he ran after the lady and flagged her down, and he said, I just had to stop you and ask you. I haven't seen you for a year. He said, how's George and his dog food fetish? Oh, she said, you didn't hear? George died. Oh, my goodness, said the doctor. It wasn't the dog food, was it? No, she said. He was sitting in the yard licking his dick one day, and I accidentally backed over him with the car.
Terrible.
That's what Wendy meant when she said, at least you're not George. Bye, everybody.